delante de mí. Así que animáis a un Héctor, no María José. Tú puedes this paper, which is strongly linked with my PhD, which I studied just months ago. That's why this is a theoretical approximation. And the main aim of this paper is to shed light on the relevant topic of information literacy. As an introduction, the quick rise of technologies are the driving force behind the unstoppable progress in our current information age. The information age started when Alan Turing developed the German computer during the Second World War. People exchange and manipulate data every day, and the information is easily accessible thanks to the new devices and gadgets. For example, my 10-year-old cousin has now a mobile phone with 24 hours connection, better than mine. When I was 10, I got a mobile phone, but it's a fake one and has gadgets inside. And now the educational system has a daunting challenge. We have to rewrite the rules and readapt ourselves in order to cope with the latest needs of our students. As the theoretical background in this paper, three bullet points: knowledge society and information society, education in the information society, and information literacy. A brief definition of knowledge society: it puts more emphasis on the use and exchange of knowledge. And information society focuses more on the information flow that composes our society. We think that information society is a more accurate definition. As Anna Zakristan states, 2013, she points out 10 characteristics about information society: the exuberance, overwhelming and diverse amount of data, omnipresence, where information is everywhere, speed, instant communication in all the world, interaction, users can exchange, create and manipulate data, inequality, emphasis the difference between first and the third world, heterogeneity, diversity of opinions and ideas about the information, confusion, not easy to choose useful data, and apathy, consume data over our own creativity. As you can see, they are not all right side. The education in information society, the educational system should change and adapt to the 21st century society, and also teachers will be prepared for this new age. It is essential if you want to change the and readapt the educational system. And last but not least, learners should be equipped not only with the use of IT tools, but also with competence in processing information. About the concept of information literacy: information means data, news, or facts, while literacy increasingly has become associated with the ability to understand and interpret specific phenomena. And information literacy as a whole describes the acquisition of a particular range or set of information that can be received. The Skonul in 2011 has created a model which defines the use of the core skills and competence that it uses in behaviors with these seven pillars that the students should have mastered right before they arrive at the university. The model is huge. You can see all the table in my report paper. This is a pretty summaries, The seven pillars are identify, scope, plan, gather, evaluate, manage, and present. And about the methodology, as I explained before, this is a brief approximation of my PhD. So I look up words like information literacy, information skills, knowledge society, and information society, in databases like ERIC or Scope. And I use impact journals in education like computers and education. Conclusions related to the theoretical background. The information society is continuously changed, which means that the education system should change too. Teachers should be prepared and trained to face this new challenge, and researchers ought to study if our students are fluent in the competencies and attitudes that this new state. And never before in the human life have we faced a huge challenge like this. We have not learned how to prepare the next generations of pupils about how to live in this information society, but we have keep trying. Thus, in my PhD, we are going soon to research about evaluating our high school students with these competencies and skills that we are really in the information literacy and knowledge. Thanks for your attention.